Happy Tuesday, nerds. My name is Dyer Barker. My friends, they call me the Hog Man. This is Project GP.
Hey guys, Godric Gray here from Dragon Masters with another Tech Tuesday with Project GP. This week, we have a Mort variant of a Smilingfoamworks sword. These swords come in at around 7.5 ounces at 36 inches long. The website says that there is no glue that is used on the blade of this sword. That allows them to pull the weight a little bit closer to the pommel. The pommel you'll notice in this video is blue, which signifies that it is a Mort variant of their swords. Let's crack it open. We're going to start by taking off the cloth tape from the handle. Alright, so we've got the cloth tape off, and now it looks like there's electrical tape at the pommel and at the blades. We're going to go ahead and take that off. So the cover is a fitted cover that is made out of ripstop. It's two-tone, and it's sewn together with a zigzag stitch. Alright, now we're going to take the electrical tape off and look at the pommel. So the pommel is covered by blue ripstop nylon, which signifies which version of the sword that you got. So underneath the ripstop, all the foam is covered in clear tape. We're gonna go ahead and remove that. The pommel appears to be made of foam that is folded in over itself and then taped to the core. Alright, so I've cut the foam away from the core here. We're going to go ahead and pull it off. So remember, we purchased the Mort variant. The Mort variant does not have any glue on the blade. Just keep that in mind as we're tearing this apart. So on their website, which we'll link down below, they sell 505 kite spar. The description of this sword doesn't tell us what the core is, but if I had to venture a guess, I'm going to say it's 505 kite spar. So the handle is made of a shark bite PEX piping. So that piping is taped down to the core. We're gonna go ahead and take that tape off now. So once we take the PEX off, you can see four different pieces of electrical tape. This electrical tape brings the outer diameter of the core to match the inner diameter of the PEX. So we've taken this puck off the top. It appears to be connected with a couple layers of carpet tape. There seem to be about 1 inch to 1.5 inches of a thicker density foam with a softer foam on top. We're gonna go ahead and cut that softer foam off. Come on. So we've got this taken apart. There seems to be a denser foam inch to an inch and a half puck here with a one layer softer foam for the stab tip. This was then taped and glued together. So this sword is made using one solid piece of octagonal foam that was torque wrapped at the base to connect it to the core. And that, my friends, wraps up this Tech Tuesday, where we just finished tearing up the Mort variant from Smilingfoamworks. My name is Godric Gray here at Dragon Masters. You're watching Project GP. We'll see you next week.